Welcome to another Desmos Minute with Jules. Today, let's talk about movable points. So if we create a point, let's say 1 and 2, we'll notice that there's a little graphic here that shows up, and when you hold long off on it, you can change the color, but you can also change the style, but you can also change how it slides. So if we notice, we can grab this point and we can grab it anywhere, and it creates a new coordinate. That's very special. But the power of Desmos is anytime you see a number, you can replace that with parameters. Let's do that right now. A and B. So if we add these parameters, we can see that now we can have a movable point, but they're parameters that are changing. So we can actually use these parameters in some equations. So let's try something with a slope and y-intercept. So if we replace A and B, the parameters in this equation, we can easily ask the students, what do you notice? What do you wonder? What's happening here? So if I change my B, which is the Y coordinate, but in this case, the Y intercept, and what happens when we move the A? And if we wanted to separate those movements into two, we can actually click this button, and we have just the x-axis or the A parameter changing now. And we can see what's happening there. So that's a great way to ask and make the students explore together. What's really cool is we can also look at rise and run with the same parameters. Now, what happens now? What are the parameters? So what do you notice? What do you wonder? A question I might ask is, what happens in each quadrant when we put the point in each quadrant? What happens when we get closer to a Y value or an X value? And there's lots of exploration and sense making to be happening there. Great thinking. And a great way to do that is to trace a point as well. So we notice here that we have a function and that's restricted to a parameter. And we can use that parameter in a movable point again with the function of that parameter, and see what, look what happens is now you can just trace a graph. That's awesome. Another one that amazes me is the cosine. So we can look at what the parameters A and B do on a cosine. And we see that A is going to change the amplitude, B is going to change the phase, and we can, the frequency, I should say. But it's very, very interesting. Now, what's really cool is we can create a point that follows the graph, a bit like trace like we did. So if we create this point with C as a parameter, and then the whole function with the C instead, even if we change the A and B, the C will always remain on that function. And we can go look at the parameters and the coordinates of this point on the curve. Great thinking happening there. And last but not least, I saw this one online and I couldn't resist. Could you imagine asking, what do you notice? What do you wonder? Grab all these circles, these points, I mean, and they create, all those three points create the circle. So imagine what we can do and what questions we can ask and what we want to find out. I'm wondering what are the possibilities of these points? How can we set them up so that we can have the center of the circle to be at the origin? How many possibilities there are? What's the relationship between the three points for the origin to be the center of the circle to be at 0, 0? That's a cool thing. So, I mean, we can start exploring all sorts of things with that and making calculations, and let's create more thinking. Go Desmos.